Today on an extra special chocolate-covered edition of Anastasia's Daily Affirmations. The topic today is how to love your husband. Yes, every man is a workaholic because they are driven to provide. One of the greatest things you can do for him, other than this is outside of the bedroom, is give him time to work. Hello and welcome to Anastasia's Daily Affirmations, the Love Yourself series. I'm Anastasia. Happy Friday. So good to be with you today. And thank you so much for pressing play. Please be sure to visit my Facebook page, Anastasia Bahamian Voice Talent. Be sure to follow and remember that I post every Tuesday and Friday. So if you're enjoying this video, there's much, much more where this came from. And I want to say thank you so much. Thank you for all of your love, all of your likes, all of your support, all of your kind words of encouragement. Thank you so much. And welcome to my page. And welcome to all of my new followers. Hey, what's going on? Thank you so much. Thank you so much for the follow. I just appreciate you so much. Thank you. Today is part two of how to attract and keep a quality man. And I'm going to use for a subtitle, and this is really actually the subject of today's episode, is really how to love your husband. How to love your husband. And I know, yes, this is the Love Yourself series, but I know that there are many of you listening who are married, who are engaged, who are contemplating marriage, and as someone who's been married for quite a minute and with the same man for many, many, many years, I do believe that I have some things that I want to share with you that I believe will help to make this new venture or the venture that you've started long ago more meaningful, more productive. And I believe that that is my responsibility. First of all, as a teacher and as a woman who has had her own experiences, I believe in passing on information and wisdom to other people. And so that is what we're going to do here today. As I shared with you in the last episode, I've spent a lot of time speaking to men about men and learning about men from men and learning about relationships, not just from external sources, but from my own experiences. And one of the things that I really believe wholeheartedly is that people give up on their relationship too quickly. They give up on marriage too quickly. And one of the reasons that I believe that that happens is because we don't understand each other. We misinterpret each other's actions, intent, even our facial expressions. We misinterpret each other, and we often tend to see each other in a defensive way. Let me tell you what I mean by that. We tend to see things through our own lens, and we tend to lean towards something being negative rather than it being a positive thing. Like if your husband says something to you, he said, "Oh, there's, just for an example, oh, there's a piece of paper on the ground." We would immediately begin to say, "Well, why is he criticizing me about not cleaning the house properly?" And that's not at all what he's saying. He's just saying that there's a piece of paper on the ground. He meant that there may be an important message on the paper. He's coming from a completely different perspective. But we tend to take things negatively first, and we tend to brace ourselves for that criticism that really is not there. And so it's important to gain an understanding, to gain knowledge, wisdom, and understanding about how to be with a man and how to be married to that specific man. And that is what this episode is all about. And that's what I'm here to do, to help you. So with that said, let's get to our affirmation for today. I'm going to give you a moment to find a nice... did I just say nice? To find a nice, comfortable spot where you can be alone by yourself. Have a moment of solitude. And we want to inhale and exhale. One more time, inhale and exhale. Just feel all of the stress just leaving your body. One more time, inhale and exhale. Today's affirmation is, every challenge I face is here to help me build the relationship of my dreams. Every challenge I face is here to help me build the relationship of my dreams. And now repeat after me. Every challenge that I face is here to help me build the relationship of my dreams. Good, so let's get into today's subject matter. And I want to say from the very outset, I don't know how this is going to hit you, but you know, it's true. And I believe in being completely authentic. I am old school when it comes to marriage. I believe in the old-fashioned way of marriage. Why? Because it simply works. The man providing, protecting, securing his family. The woman is his helper, his supporter, the nurturer, and the builder of the home. I believe that that is how God created it. That's how he designed it. And it works because of our inherent needs. A man needs to provide. I said that in the last episode. He is a consummate provider. And a woman needs to nurture. We need to care for. We need to make sure that everything is in order. And we are that perfect help meet. And the term help meet, not help mate, but help meet, means a helper who is appropriate, an appropriate helper. So when the Bible refers to a woman or a wife as a help meet to her husband, that word meet means sufficient or appropriate. And so we are that fulcrum for our husbands. We are that soft place for him to land while he's out there on the battlefield bringing home the bacon. I believe that a man needs to have that ability to lead and carry and bear the burden of his family. That is what he was designed to do. And I think that a big part of why I am such a believer in the old school is because of my upbringing. My father was the breadwinner and my mom was a stay-at-home mom and a housewife. And I stayed with her at home for the first 5 years of my life. I never went to kindergarten. I learned my ABCs and 1-2-3s from Sesame Street. Hi, Big Bird. and I had no issues going into grade one. And those first 5 years of my life were very, very crucial. And I learned from my mom how to be a consummate wife. I learned that just from observing her, just from being in the home with her. My mom she's an excellent wife. She taught me how to serve my husband. She really did, because of the way that she handles my father. I watched her do it. And so I have some things that I want to share. Let's get really into it. I believe that there are some attitudes and mindsets that you need to adorn even long before you get married, before you even sign up to be married. And you know, a lot of people want to be married. There's a stigma about women not being married that is not deserved, and it is incorrect, because every woman was not designed to be married. Every woman is not a wife. Some women, their purpose is to remain single, and that is okay. And you shouldn't feel pressured into being married. You shouldn't feel pressured. Don't let anyone pressure you, and don't put that pressure on yourself. But I believe that when you sign up for marriage, it will serve you well to have an attitude of service, of sacrifice, and a willingness to work, because those are the three things, the three core things that will be required of you to serve your husband and your family. As I shared with you in a previous episode, when I was 16 years old, I began consciously preparing myself to be a wife, began studying Proverbs 31, and it really happened organically for the most part, because I spent a lot of time at home. I spent a lot of time at home. And one of my responsibilities as the last born, besides being everybody's gopher, thank you so much, was to keep the house clean. My parents have a 5-bedroom, 3-bathroom house. And my job every day was to clean that house from front to back. I had to cook when mommy was not at home. And I really started cooking when I was 8 years old. It was something that I just naturally love to do. I'm a foodie. I love to cook and bake. And that's just so organic to me. But I think that it is important to know how to do these things. I believe that it is. I believe it's important to know how to cook, how to clean your house if you're going to get married, because these skills become very essential. I mean, you don't want to eat fast food every night, do you? You don't want to eat fast food every night. And it's more than just nutrition and diet, although that is very important. It's also the art of making memories and making your home a sanctuary. Creating memories for your family, for your husband, for your children, for yourself. One of the greatest memories from my childhood, I can still smell it right now, is coming home to a hot homemade meal. Whether it was pea soup and dumplings, or corned beef and rice, or I can still remember one day, oh my God, mommy was making some super tender curried mutton with carrots and potatoes and peppers and aromatics and thyme and just enough goat pepper to have your eyes running but keep you out of the emergency room, you know? And she was making a nice pot of fluffy, hot, buttered, salted white rice to go on the side with crunchy coleslaw. Oh my God. I can still remember the smell of that wafting through the neighborhood. You know, that's a memory that I can tag to my mother. Freshly baked bread, I can tie that to her, because she used to make pea soup and dumplings with freshly baked coconut bread. That smell just transports me right back to my childhood. And so it's creating an atmosphere in your home, one that is inviting. One where he wants to come home. Do you think of how comforting that feels when you walk through a door? That when you come home to the smell of a wonderfully prepared meal, it's just beautiful, and it's something that you will do well to learn. Don't let anyone tell you, "Oh, that's old-fashioned. That's out of style." It is old-fashioned, and that's a good thing. That's a very good thing. Old school is good school. Don't throw away the old for everything that's new. Some things back then worked very well. Very, very well. So I believe that in taking care of your husband, prepare yourself to be a wife. Prepare yourself to be specifically his wife. Look at yourself as someone providing a service for your husband, for your friend, for someone that you care about and love. And do it, and you're doing it because you want to make sure that he's good. You know, let me tell you, when my husband comes home from work, I help him take his shoes off. I help him take his socks off. I get him a cold drink. I help make him feel comfortable if I am at home when he gets home. I help to make that transition comfortable for him. I put his shoes away in the closet, put his socks away. That is what I do. And some people may look at that and say, oh, this is not 1950. No, it's not. But a man will always need that, whether it's 1950 or or 3050. The nature of a man will not change. He will always need a woman who supports him, who's a soft place for him to fall. And I do these things not because I'm subservient. I know exactly who I am. And who I am is a person who loves my husband. And I view him not just as my husband, but as my friend. And I want to just be kind to him. That's how I look at it. I want to serve him. And then sacrifice. I talked a few episodes back about sacrifice. I think it was the first episode. That sometimes you're not going to get your way. And be willing to let him have his way. And you know what? A man will always let you have your way more often than he does. That's what I've found. He will. If a man loves you, he will always let you have more of your way than he has of his way. Because his living desire is to see you happy, to put that smile on your face, and to know that he put that there, that you are content with him, and he is doing a good job in keeping you satisfied. And then be prepared to work. As soon as I got married, listen, washing is not an option. You have to wash. You have to cook. You have to clean. You have to maintain and manage a household immediately. There is no option. There is no option. You have to get right to work. He has to get to work providing. The light bill has to be paid. The mortgage has to be paid, the water bill, the food bill, the new dress bill. All of these items need to be secured. And the home needs to be secured. And so work will be your immediate responsibility when you get married. And so I say, if you're getting married or if you're married and you haven't been looking at marriage from that perspective, try seeing it as a service, as a sacrifice, and a work. It will make it much easier than trying to have your way all of the time in every situation and trying to be served. And you will find that he will be more willing to do things for you when you love and appreciate him. Secondly, one of the key attitudes that I believe that you should employ when trying to keep your man of quality, you got him, girl, and now you're trying to maintain him, is to believe that every problem has a solution. Every problem has a solution. Go down the aisle thinking and knowing in your heart, beyond any shadow of a doubt, that every problem that you face in your relationship has a solution. And that's not just with marriage, that's with life on the whole. You know, and when I embarked on this venture, Anastasia's Daily Affirmations, I kept hearing the Holy Spirit say to me, problems have solutions. Every problem has a solution. And Stevie Wonder has a song. I like Stevie Wonder, so I'm going to be quoting him sometimes. He has a song called You Will Know. And there's a line in that that says, problems have solutions. Trust and I will show. And that I, of course, is God that he's talking about. But every problem has a solution. And what I've found is that whenever you set out on a good venture, and notice exclamation on the word good. When you set out on a good venture, what I call a fire-breathing dragon, that's how I like to describe it, a fire-breathing dragon, life assigns one to you. It has your name on it. There's the dragon, and just insert your name right here. Boom. This dragon is a fire-breathing dragon. He is assigned to chase you and to breathe fire on your back. every time that you set out to do a good thing. And a lot of people misinterpret the dragon and the fire. They think that the dragon is there to kill them. Oh, he's going to eat me. Or he's going to incinerate me to pieces. Yosemite Sam would call it to smithereens. He is there to singe the life out of me. No. And this is the same thing. That dragon is a type of the devil. It is the same thing that we do with the devil. The devil is here to destroy me. We blame everything on the devil. And we blame everything on the dragon. This dragon is trying to kill me. No, it's not. The dragon is there to help you achieve the things that you pray for. You think that when you pray for something, that God is just going to zap you with it. Don't worry, girl. I thought that too. I used to pray for patience so much. When I became a Christian, back when I was 16 years old, I used to pray for patience so much until I realized that God is not going to zap me with patience, because I just wanted him to, you know, translate me into patience, Jesus. Yeah. Let there be light. Let there be patient Anastasia. That's what I wanted. That's what I thought that he was going to do. However, the way to gain patience is to deal with some nasty, salty, bitter, ugly people who look like they've been eating nasty, salty, ugly, bitter fruit all day. And so I stopped praying for patience. I said, Lord, I realized that when I pray for patience, all of these hellish things are going to start breaking out against me. And I'm not ready for all of them. So I am very patient. See, I am very patient. I don't need any more lessons. Thank you so much. Amen. And I'll wait for you to answer. That's how patient I am. Thanks. But that dragon is there. It's there to push you. You see, because we don't accomplish great things in comfort and in satisfaction. We accomplish great things in discomfort, in pain, in stress. That's how a bodybuilder builds muscle. In order to build muscle, he has to put weight on his arms. And the weight on his arms destroys the muscle. It breaks it down. And then it keloids. And that is why you see a man with a lot of muscles, like my handsome husband. He has gone through a lot of stress, pressure, and discomfort to get that. It looks good, but it is very painful to achieve. However, if you can endure the pain, you will be just fine. You will receive the results. And so understand, every problem has a solution. When you get married, the dragon is coming. I'm telling you right now, I can smell his fumes. He is on his way for you. But God is with you. He is there to help you. That is not your enemy. That is the one that is going to help you achieve the things you set out to achieve. The dragon is your friend. Use him to your advantage. Next, understand that you're in a relationship with someone who is very, very different from you. A man is just very different from a woman. He is as demure as a bulldozer. And as dainty as a cactus. He's just different. You know, they like to scratch and, you know, belch and other stuff and eat their boogers. Ew. And they don't like to take showers all the time. God help. But, you know, that's a part of being a man. And part of why he does that is because his focus is on providing. No time to shower. Must provide. I think that's the voice that they're hearing in their head. He'll get around to it. Just leave him. Let him be. Let him be himself. Let him have time with the boys or whatever he likes to do for recreation. Give him that time. Some me time. Everyone needs me time. And then you can have you time. Right. Let him go out so that you can have your time to do what you need to do. Amen. Okay. And you know, it's obvious that men and women are different. But I'm talking about the things that aren't so obvious, like the fact that our brains are completely different. A man's brain is made up of compartments. Think of a disposable clamshell container, you know, with the compartments in it. There's one for the meat, there's one for the rice, there's one for the crispy, creamy, sweet and tangy coleslaw that's so crunchy. You have to forgive me, I'm a foodie. His brain has compartments, little boxes. And there's one box for his family. There's one box for his job, his career. There's one box for his playtime. There's a box for everything in his life. And he focuses on one box at a time. Men are single focus. Whereas we as women, our brains are more like a bowl. We don't have those compartments. We have just one bowl. And everything exists in that one bowl together. There is family, there is work, there's our children, there's our hopes, there's our dreams, there are hurts, our frustrations, they all exist in one bowl. And so when we go through something, it tends to bleed into everything else. Whereas men have the ability to pin things. That's the way that my husband describes it, pinning. They have a way of putting it on the back burner in one of those compartments and just focusing on the main priority. They are wired and designed to do that very, very well. And so you're dealing with someone who is very different from you. Your husband is not a woman in a suit. And to all of the men listening, your wife is not a man in a dress. Is that a revelation? We're as different as night and day. So it will take an enormous amount of understanding, of getting to learn and understand, and acceptance of one another in order to build a lasting and fulfilling relationship. And I mean a relationship where that lasts decades, and you're not just still together for the kids, and you're not just still together because it's cheaper to just stay together and not get a divorce, or you're living in two different parts of the house, but I mean an emotionally connected, supportive, caring, loving relationship. It requires that you learn and understand. And so congratulations to you for listening to this podcast, because you are learning how to do just that from moi. Look at you. The topic today is how to love your husband. I've got many, many more tips that I want to share with you. But first, we take this commercial break and return after this. February is the love month. And anyone who knows me knows that I love. Oh my. I also know that the foundation of all loving relationships is a loving relationship with yourself. Improving the way you see and value yourself changes the way you live your life. And that change must begin with knowing and appreciating your value. One of the greatest ways to cultivate a strong, positive self-image is through affirmations. Affirmations are positive statements about yourself spoken aloud that challenge and conquer negative thoughts, and it also relieves stress. It works. It's a practice I began in my early 20s, and I would love to share some of my secrets with you. So if you want to improve your relationships, develop a greater self-confidence, and increase your value, stay tuned right here to my Facebook page for Anastasia's Daily Affirmations, the Love Yourself series. Hubba hubba. I will be posting videos every Tuesday and Friday during the month of February, beginning this Tuesday, February 1st. So love yourself and join me for Anastasia's Daily Affirmations, the Love Yourself series. It's going to be so much fun. See you then. Welcome back to Anastasia's Daily Affirmations, the Love Yourself series. I'm Anastasia. Today's topic is how to keep a quality man. And for a subtitle, how to love your husband. And today's affirmation is, every challenge I face is here to help me build the relationship of my dreams. So my last point was that we're very different. We are very, very different. And those differences are where I believe the core of our issues lie as men and women, as husband and wife. It's kind of like a Frenchman who only speaks French getting together with a Bahamian who only speaks English. And so when he walks up to you, he says, "Bonjour, comment allez-vous? Je m'appelle Jean, enchanté. Quel est votre nom?" And you're looking at him like, what is this French Negro saying? What franglais is this man talking to me? And then when you say to him, "Hi, my name is Jane. How are you? It's good to meet you. What's your name?" He's looking at you like, what is her problem and how can I fix it? You know, because men are fixers. But you see how it creates such a barrier. It's like speaking two completely different languages. And so it's important to learn how to interpret, and it's important to learn how to speak the other person's language. That includes their love language. Do you know your partner's love language? What's your husband's love language? Do you know what yours is? That's important to learn because we truly do feel, you know, women generally, we love affection and we love connection and we are very emotional and we love words. We love to be complimented and told that we're beautiful. We love to hear those words of those affirming words. We really do. And men who are mission focused, they are providers. Men like to solve problems. They like to get out there and make sure that they are providing for their families. That gives them a sense of calm and a sense of fulfillment. And that relieves their stress knowing that they are handling all of the little battles out there so that you and his family are safe and secure at home. And so it's good to understand. It's good to understand. Women like to snuggle. We like him to be close to us, don't we? Girl, I like to snuggle. Oh my God. I just love snuggling up with my husband on the couch, watching TV. And you know, just enjoying his presence, smelling his neck. And anyway, ooh, too much. Is that TMI? But I just love that connection. But I realize I can't always have that connection. We can't always be snuggling up on the couch, even though that's what I want, because I have already told you I am ooey gooey. I'm a hopeless romantic. You know, he has to work and I have to give him time and space to work, because that is how he is relieved of his stress, knowing that he has covered the priorities and the base is covered. Provision is a man's number one priority, and his provision is not about him wanting to be away from you and always wanting to work and being a workaholic. Every woman's husband is a workaholic. Girl, welcome to the club. Hi, how you doing? Yes, every man is a workaholic because they are driven to provide. And so they give him one of the greatest things you can do for him, other than this is outside of the bedroom, is give him time to work. And he will eventually come back to you to snuggle up on the couch because that's where he wants to be too. But he just needs to make sure that you're covered in terms of his provision. And so you need the affection. He needs that space to work. He needs that respect from you. He needs your support. He needs you to understand when he is out there on the battlefield, that is your soldier. He's working for you. A lot of times we don't see it that way. We think that he's just out there and he doesn't want to spend any time with us. But that's not what it is at all. He is working for you. Did you realize that? Men, sometimes your wife doesn't understand that, you know. Sometimes she doesn't know that. Because in her mind, if you love me, you'll spend time with me. You'll come and hug me and you'll be with me. But in your mind, you're thinking, I love her, so I have to go out there and work and provide. And do you see where you're speaking French and she's speaking English? Do you see that? Mm-hmm. It's real. Happens all the time. That's why I'm here, to help fill in the blanks. I didn't want to help you. So, yeah. And so we're different. And accept him. Accept him for who he is. Allow him to be himself. just as he allows you to be yourself. Allow your wife to be who she is. She is going to cry sometimes. Women like, we are detail-oriented. We like experiences. We like to enjoy the journey, whereas men like to enjoy the achievement, the acquisition of the goal. That's what they're after. They are mission-focused. So let me give you an example. I love shopping. Most women do. I love going to the grocery store, getting the trolley, putting on the sanitizer, going from aisle to aisle, picking up items from the shelf, looking at them, checking the price, checking the ingredients. I love all that. I love the cold air conditioner. I love the smell of the store and the lights and all of that. And I tend to take my time shopping, which drives my husband bananas, because even though he loves me and that's why he's with me, he hates shopping. Men generally don't like shopping, so please give him a pass if he doesn't want to shop with you. It is as boring as watching paint dry for him, because when my husband goes to the food store, it's zip, zap, zooey, and out of there. And it's like that for most men. He is mission focused. I came to get my eggs, my milk, a loaf of bread, a container of milk, and a stick of butter. Right. That's it. And he is gone out of there. So women like the experience, the detail. Men like the achievement, the end goal, right? Different, but all good. Both of those perspectives are necessary. So moving on, for those of you who have children, and I know it's important to care for your kids, to love them, to nurture them, and they're very needy. They need you in many, many ways. Let me just say to you, while you're loving your children, don't forget about your husband. When you are hugging them and kissing them and kissing their boo-boos and rubbing their heads and talking to them in that kind, sweet voice and getting down on your knees to their level so that you can see them in their eyes, remember to do the same things with your husband. He wants his head rubbed too. He wants his face kissed and his lips kissed. He wants you to rub his head, to hold him. He wants you to say attaboy and to kiss his boo-boos. He wants to lay on you. He wants your nurturing and care. Don't forget about him. Because I think that a lot of women tend to allow the children to take over the family, and that becomes the primary relationship, when it really is your relationship with your husband. That is the primary relationship, and the children should not infringe on that relationship, as they often do. But it's up to you to decide. You don't want your husband feeling like an outsider in the family, like that's the family over there and I'm just here observing. You don't want that, because that is when a man tends to get in trouble, when he starts to drift, when he starts to look elsewhere outside of your home. So be very vigilant about making time to nurture him as well. He doesn't need a lot, but he does need you, and he wants you. And he probably won't say anything, you know, because he understands that you have to take care of the kids and that's your focus. He understands that. But yet he still has needs. If deer pant for water, you know, if they pant for water, they get hungry. He gets hungry for that. He gets hungry for you. So feed him. And speaking of feeding, let's go to the bedroom. Hi! Welcome to the boudoir. Stop it, Anastasia. This one, I don't know how pervasive it is, but I do know that there are some people that deal with this. Leave the church woman in you at church. Do not bring her into the bedroom. Can I get an amen? Can I get a glow to God? Can I get a hallelujah? And I know all of the men are going to back me up on this one. They're going to be cheering me. Yes, Anastasia! Leave the church woman at church. Leave her at church. leave her at church. And I have to be careful what I say because I don't want my video to get muted. Okay, like previous ones have been. However, he needs sex. There's a saying, don't be so heavenly that you're no earthly good. I agree with that. That applies to the bedroom. A man needs sex. He needs it. However, whatever, the marriage bed is undefiled. Man wants a lady in the streets and a you-know-what in the sheets. Be that. If you have to learn, learn. Learn. Learn his buttons. Learn what they are. And maximize his satisfaction. Because, again, we all hunger. And when he eats, you want him to eat at home. Home-cooked meals. You don't want him going to these fast food places for their greasy, nasty, ugly burgers and chicken and stuff. You want him to eat at home. And so make the eating good. Got my point? Amen. Let's move on. And so wrapping up, I covered so much in episode 3, which was the first part of this lesson. And I would encourage you to go back and listen to that one. Listen to that one as well. And then come back and listen to this one again. Because I mentioned so many things in there that are so important for you as a woman to employ in order to facilitate the productivity of your relationship and to maximize it. Men need that love and concern, that care, that softness, the unique femininity that you bring to counter his rough and tumble, meat and potatoes, provider, go-getter, you know, warrior. That warrior energy, it needs a soft place to fall, and you're it. You're it. Accept him for who he is. Respect your husband. Respect him. Don't criticize him too much. Compliment him way more than you criticize him, because his living desire, everything that your husband is doing, is to please you. Trust me. If you don't believe me, ask him. It is not because he doesn't want to be at home. And I notice that I like to quote songs. Bobby Womack has a song, If You Think You're Lonely Now. There's a line in there that says, he's basically saying, you know, when I go to work, you want me to be home on the couch snuggling with you. I understand that, though. And then when I'm at home snuggling with you and we don't have any money, you're complaining that you don't have anything to eat. The lights are off. He said, I can't be at two places at the same time. And so give him space to work. And know that he will come home. He will come home and snuggle with you. That's what he wants to do too. But he just has to make sure that base is covered. And so how to love your husband, how to keep that quality man that you've snagged. Congratulations. This is Anastasia's Daily Affirmations, the Love Yourself series. Thank you so much for tuning in. And today's affirmation is, every challenge I face is here to help me build the relationship of my dreams. Thank you so much for listening. I really appreciate you. And listen, if there is a specific topic that you would like for me to address, please inbox me and let me know. I am, like I said, I don't know everything, but I do know some things and I am willing to share. Remember to visit my Facebook page, Anastasia Bahamian Voice Talent. Press follow and you will receive a notification every time I upload. So until Tuesday, and Monday is Valentine's Day. So happy Valentine's Day. And until next time, remember, like apples of gold in pictures of silver is a word fitly spoken. I'm Anastasia. Have a fantastic weekend. God bless and peace.